it. All of the country's Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA, sites or installations is in the crosshairs of China's rocket fire arsenal of hypersonic missiles. An unconfirmed assertion that has sent shivers on a distinguished senator who is sounding the alarm in the event the Reds decide to push down the button and need for more affirmative information that our Patrick DeJesus details in this report.
Sa tingin ng China, talagang kumampi na tayo sa kalaban nila.
Senator Amy Marcus expressed concern about what she claims is a plan that holds water or credibility that China's hypersonic missiles are allegedly pointed toward certain places in the Philippines. The senator said this is due to the additional EDCA sites in the country and rising tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
Talaga mainit ang ulo nila. Eh, natatakot talaga ako. Hindi naman nila iniisip na lulusog dito sa Pilipinas yung katakot-takot na army nila, mga navy nila. Hindi ganoon. Ang plano, air.
Senator Amy added that China has 25 targets in the Philippines, including Batanes, Subic, and Ilocos.
At nakatakda na yung 25 na target nila. Kitang-kita na. Ang sabi ng US, hindi daw nila kaya labanan yung hypersonic missile. Mas lalo akong ninervyos kasi akala ko kapag missile, meron yung ibang bansa yung tinatawag na Iron Dome, hindi makapasok yung missile. Kapag hypersonic daw, kayang-kaya pumasok. Ganyan lang kadali, durog daw.
The Armed Forces of the Philippines takes the information reportedly received by the senator seriously. The AFP will coordinate with her to obtain details before taking appropriate actions to ensure nation security. Hypersonic weapons are highly maneuverable and can travel at 5 times the speed of sound. Meanwhile, despite the tensions in the West Philippine Sea, AFP Chief of Staff General Romeo Browner Jr. allayed fears of war.
Sa ngayon po ay ang masasabi po natin is that we are still in control of the situation. Hindi po magkakagera. No? Hindi po magkakagera. Dahil ginagamit po natin lahat ng instruments of national power. Hindi lamang po kasi military ang instrument of national power natin. We have economic, information, and diplomacy. Mm-hmm. Ayaw po natin magkagera kasi talo po tayong lahat. No? Tayong mga Pilipino, so sino man yung sasakop sa atin or gustong sumakop sa atin, talo rin sila, no? Dahil wala pong mananalo sa gera.
Related to this, the 9th Bilateral Consultation Mechanism meeting between the Philippines and China was held yesterday. Here, DFA Undersecretary Maria Teresa Lazaro and Chinese Vice Foreign Minister Chen Xiaodong discussed easing tensions in the West Philippine Sea. The two officials also agreed to continue discussions on maritime cooperation, including possible continuation of the Joint Coast Guard Committee. Patrick DeJesus from the National TV for a new and better Philippines.